You are listening to I Am Refocused Radio with your host, Shamaya Reed. This show is designed to inspire you to live your purpose and regain your focus. And now, here's your host, Shamaya Reed.
Welcome to I Am Refocused Radio. This is your host, Shamaya Reed. This is a Sunday morning right here on 9:30 a.m. The Answer. I just want to say thank you to everybody who's listening to the show. Man, it is amazing the momentum that is carrying right now. We have a special guest. You know what time it is. It's that time of the month where we have the coach, B Michele. She's in the building, the studio, and we're going to be talking about building the brand, showing up.
Yes.
So welcome to the show. How you doing, man?
Thank you. As always, it's a pleasure. I'm good. I feel like I'm burning the candle at both ends right now, but hopefully it'll smooth out here in a little while. You've got some major projects on tap. But other than that, I'm good and happy to be here.
Staying busy, man. Staying busy.
Yeah, it's wild out here in this entrepreneur life. It's wild and, you know, clients. Just people, just stuff.
Life happens, man.
Yes. Life.
Speaking of life happening, man, that's just proof that you're doing something important. Because if you're not doing anything important, then what are you doing?
Right.
You're just kind of living a boring life, man.
I know, right? I think we'll have to definitely kind of talk about this subject as far as it relates to even personal stuff. Because somebody was saying, even talking about just goals, like you should totally have personal goals as well as like business goals and career goals. So we might have to talk about that one.
There's a major gap if you don't have personal goals.
Yeah. So we might just have to do a goals segment on goals.
All right. So speaking of showing up, building your brand, explain to the audience what this topic is going to be all about today.
So, okay. So this one kind of came to me like, honestly, like everything else does in my sleep. And so when I wake up, I just kind of grab my phone and start typing.
Okay.
And so I think I realized that, you know, when you're especially for small business owners and those that are getting started now, are new on their journey and figuring out who they are as a brand, who they are as a business. The most important thing is creating that memory, because that's what branding is about. It's about the memory. It's about the emotion that your client or your customer feels when you interact with them and when they use your product or they, you know, purchase your service. And so, but a part of creating that experience is showing up.
Yeah.
And so I was like, you have to show up on a number of levels, and really three levels, actually.
There's levels to this, man.
So you know how we go through our analogies with sports, right?
Uh-huh.
So of course I kind of built this thing around sports just to kind of make it make sense.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, okay, so let's just say no matter what sport it is, it's three phases. The game takes place in three phases. Typically it's practice. So and practice is more so you're honing your skill, you mm-hmm. know. So in this case, far as showing up in the practice phase, that's you building a relationship. You're getting to know your potential client. You're getting to know your customer, just even networking.
Mm-hmm.
So that's showing up and really showing that your client is showing your customer that, you know, you care about them.
Yeah.
Okay. Because no matter what, even though you may not build a relationship this one-on-one, you can build a relationship with your clients through media and through other platforms. But especially if you have a business like I have where it's coaching and you work with a lot of people and you interact with people on a daily basis, you can still build relationships with them if you have that type of business.
Yeah.
To where you do interact with your client or customer face to face a lot. So in practice, that's you really letting your client and your customer know that you care about them. That's where you're building that trust at.
Yeah.
Okay. So when they decide to make that purchase, they need to feel good about that purchase. They need to walk away feeling like they just spent the best $2 or the best $2,000 of their life.
Yeah, they shouldn't be feeling bad or feeling nervous.
Right. Not at all. They should not second guess their purchase. They should not get in the car and have buyer's remorse, as they call it.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so what, you know, as you, you know, interact with them, you communicate, you talk, you get to know them, whatever platforms you use to market and brand to get your message out there to, you know, your target audience, that's that practice phase. That's you, you know, all right, so here's what we do, letting your potential audience, letting your target audience and potential client know that we can do this, mm-hmm. you know. And so the next phase is like, okay, it's game day.
Yeah.
And that's where, okay, so we've been to practice, we got our skills together, we, you know, built a relationship, you know, we're good. So now it's time to execute. So this is the execution phase. Mm-hmm. So especially if it's a product based and you buy something, you expect it to work or do whatever it's supposed to do. And it's just like for you, for let's say, you know, technology, like microphones and headsets and all other stuff you need to produce your show. You need it to do exactly what that company said it was going to do. Mm-hmm. And as if you're in a service based industry, especially hair, like barbershops, beauty salons, even coaching and those type of things, like, I need my cut, my hair.
Right.
That, I need the whole thing. So yeah. Whatever you promise in the practice phase,
deliver.
You have to deliver on game day. Mm-hmm. Like, you have to execute.
That's what practice is for. That's what training is for. It's to be ready to make it happen.
Is to get ready. So all that stuff you was talking,
back it up.
During practice, like, it's time to back it up.
Like the cloud, man. You better have a backup, man.
Right. Like the cloud. You're right. That's a good one. Like the cloud, you better have a backup. And I always say it's kind of like you have to, and I don't know, you can tell me if I'm able to say this or not, but I feel like it's kind of like you got to be like Jordan in the fourth quarter type situation.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
MJ, it's all good.
Yeah. So it's like you kind of got to have, you got to bring your MJ-ness. Mm-hmm. To it.
Gotta
and
drink
like
that good water.
Yeah. Drink that good water and really just come to kill it. Like, honestly.
Yeah.
And that way, so because that brand, that's you, that's the brand, right? That's that brand development right there. That's where that emotion comes from. That's where your clients like, okay, they're going to tell everybody.
That's that value.
That's that value.
Appreciate.
Right. That's you delivering on the value that mm-hmm. you promised. If that makes sense.
Oh, that makes total sense.
So, that's you creating the experience. That's you getting to see your client's emotion behind it. That's all of that. And that's what really creates your brain. And that's what keeps people coming back to you. And that's what keeps people telling other people about you. And your experience in the process of. That's that game day execution is what really can make or break your business. And especially as a small business owner, those are key elements and key components to help you stay in business. This is why I always say, I mean, you know, lately I haven't seen you since last month. So one of the things that I said I was going to post about it is that I feel like branding is like the stepchild of business development. Yeah. Like nobody thinks about us. We kind of just off in the cut somewhere. Mm-hmm. When really we should get treated like your firstborn.
Yeah.
Like, honestly.
No, that's true, man.
We should be treated like your firstborn because, really, you need to establish yourself and develop and to see who you are as a brand before you can even market anything.
Oh, yeah.
Because if you don't know who you are as a brand, like, who are you marketing to? If you haven't figured out your niche.
They don't know and you don't know.
Right. They don't know and you don't know.
And like someone told me last week, what you don't know, you don't know.
Right.
So, you know.
But you can't continue.
Yeah, you can't do that vicious cycle.
Yeah.
You gotta stop and catch yourself, man.
Right. You totally have to stop and catch yourself.
It's called maintenance.
Maintenance.
And it's like having a car. If you don't do maintenance on your car, well, if you think you're just gonna wake up every single day and drive that car every single day and you don't have to do any maintenance, good luck.
Right. And so you always have to do maintenance on your business. And this is where developing that brand and creating that experience.
Showing up, man.
And showing up. You have to show up in the whole process. And even in...
I like that.
Even in the execution part of it, if something happens to go wrong, you have to show up and fix it. You gotta show up for the good and the bad.
Mm-hmm. Metaphors all day, because I have to say... It's like school, you know. You're going to class. You got to show up every day, whether you feel like it or you don't. I mean, you got homework assignments. You got to show up and you got to do it. It's the same thing with business. It's the same thing with your life. You have to take every single small detail and find out where you're lacking.
Right.
And say, okay, I'm going to be honest with myself. And I'm going to say, okay, I'm weak in this area of my life. Let me do better in that area. Because sometimes in business, we only count the wins. We don't pay attention to the losses.
Oh, you definitely have to count them L's.
I mean,
like, you should probably just spend more time on the L's than you do the wins.
Exactly.
because the L's is what's going to make you better. Yeah. The L's is where you do the tweaking at. That's where the maintenance comes in, and you fixing the things that went wrong with this situation or whatever this plan that you had that didn't go right, or you took a shot, you know, here and it didn't work out. So those L's is really where, again, it's you still showing up in your business and showing up enough to be able to fix it. And so the third part is showing up, you know, as any game, there's always that post-interview, that after game. And so I kind of...
It's just the proof of what you did.
Right.
Or did not do.
Right. So I kind of equate this to the whole, to this as follow-up. So, you know, that post-game interview is where you go, you answer all the questions, you look at everything that happened, you get the feedback, you know, whatnot. So it's the same thing in business, and as you start to develop your brand, is the follow-up. Contacting your clients, asking, you know, their experience. Number one, even making sure you know, ask them to leave you a review on Google, or whatever platforms you have.
Yeah.
And going to check the reviews. If you didn't get a not-so-good one, hey, reach out.
Yeah.
Respond to the review. Hit them with a phone call if you happen to have their contact info, whatever, you know, reach out, show up again. It's just about showing up in that experience, because I promise you, as long as you show up, your clients and your customers will totally appreciate that. And that's what will give you the longevity in your business and be able to build the brand and leave the legacy that, you know, you're trying to leave for your family. Showing up. It's so funny because I told them in the post that I put on, I think it was Instagram or the LinkedIn, you know, we all know the saying, you know, knowing is half the battle. But when it comes to business and branding, is showing up is half the battle.
Oh, yeah.
It's really a good portion. It's most of the battle. But it's definitely half of it.
You're better than 99% of people who don't show up.
Yeah.
And if you're just now tuning in, this is IMB Focus Radio on 9:30 a.m. The Answer, time to be Michele. Coach B, I just thought of it.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. So, no, I think that follow-up is crucial. Yeah. Because the follow-up is kind of what takes you over. Mm-hmm. It's kind of what takes you over the hump. And when you get that phone call, that email, or however you know, whatever process you have in place to follow up with your clients, trust and believe is noted.
Yeah.
You know, and again, it's part of that experience. It's part of creating that experience. And that's going to be the thing that's going to make your customers say, hey, go check out so-and-so.
Because they care.
Because they care.
Because who wants to do business with someone who doesn't care?
Right.
That's not a good look for anybody involved. Like, you're talking about being awkward and having that, what you call that customer? What you call that?
What you said, being awkward and...
Like, you said something early in the show about a customer having, you know, regrets doing business.
Oh, buyer's remorse.
I like that. I like that because that's a true fact when you're not paying attention to the actual client.
Right.
Because you almost neglect their needs.
Right.
Like, you're just worrying about the transaction, but not the actual care.
Right. And there's a saying that goes, like, people don't care until they know you care.
Mm-hmm.
And that's true. And when your clients and your customers know that you care about them, they'll be your biggest advocate. They'll be your brand ambassadors. They'll be your biggest advocates, mm-hmm. you know, in your marketplace. And with, you know, people that need your services and products. And I'm telling you, it's funny because as much as it's really important for me that I show up, but I think not to toot my own horn, but I look back at my own business and realize, okay, this is a strength that I have. So showing up, and I just really looked at how showing up really has helped grow my business.
Yeah.
And being able to be there for my clients. And that's another thing. Showing up is also being there for your clients when they're not purchasing anything.
That's a good point right there.
Right, and that's the part that's kind of in that follow-up stage.
Mm-hmm.
It's about being there. Like, I have a client, she just had surgery, had another client who recently had a stroke. So, and I made sure I sent them a message, just encouraging, letting them know that I'm, you know, keeping them in prayer and thinking about them and everything.
Yeah.
And so, like, I need to do my follow-up because that was last week. So I probably, you know, sent out another message this week just checking on them. And I had several clients that one had a knee surgery. So just throughout the process, I made sure that I just checked in on her,
mm-hmm.
and made sure that, you know, she was good to go. And we actually just recently had, She's recovered well, and so we just actually had another meeting about developing her brand. She's a therapist, and so I think that it's important that you have to show up for your clients even when they're not paying any invoices.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, honestly.
And when you are maturing as a business owner, entrepreneur, whatever you want to call yourself, CEO, whatever, titles are nothing.
Right.
Just by the way. But that gives that humble pie that makes them feel like, wow, this person actually cares.
Right.
And they actually have value. Because no one cares if you have the latest technology and the latest whatever trends.
Yep.
If you don't show that human element.
Man.
That's crucial.
And that is, and that's honestly, it's funny that you brought that up, because it's actually even true through social media as well. Like, all of your posts cannot be just straight business posting. You can't just be tagging up people on, you know, flyers and just business writing. You have to break the monotony. Like, I post articles, like, you know, post some articles about, share, you know, stuff that's happening in your industry. Share somebody else's stuff. You know, let people see a human side to you as well, even through social media and through your ads. And, you know, because if it's just all business, people will tune out. Or if you just going all the way, if, like, if you going hard in the paint about something that you
by
do
yourself,
like, it could be annoying and people start unfriending you or unfollowing you, or just, you know, scroll, just keep scrolling. If they see your post come up, they'll just keep scrolling. You want people, you want people to scroll, like, oh man, that was, I want to see, you know, you want them to scroll back down if they scroll too fast, like, because they know you always put out good content. So you don't want people to just keep scrolling, feel like they didn't miss anything, because they get used to your posts always being about trying to sell them something.
Yeah.
And so it's important that you do differentiate your content on social media. And that's an element of showing up, you know, even showing up through social media is important. And being strategic about how you show up. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I think today, when I just posted this morning about, since it's Throwback Thursday, I posted a picture of me and a friend of mine. It's her birthday today. But just talking about how you have to remember that people come into your life for a season, a reason, or a lifetime. Mm-hmm. But it's up to you to know the difference.
Yeah.
And so in that, you know, just kind of break them. And I share a ton of different stuff on my page. Sometimes I'm like, okay, let me put some business stuff up here, because I look at my page and it'll be interesting. And I got to, like, okay, let me bring it back. Yeah. So I think just showing up, you know, definitely through social media. But the main thing is that you show up for your clients and your customers and show up in your business, because how you show up is really what lays that foundation.
I ain't singing black.
Yeah. that's the foundation for development.
Presentation is key, man, because you need to show up for your first and last name. You know? Because when you walk in the room, people should be like, oh man, so-and-so is here. We know it's locked down.
You know,
man,
that's funny? Look, you must have been all in my head today. So a week ago, so I'm out with some friends at a spot, and so walk in, the music playing. So the guy, the MC, has a mic, you know, he getting the crowd hype or whatever. And all of a sudden he was like, B Michele in the building. And I was like, I'm thinking, do I know you?
Wow.
Okay, so mind you, I did have my name on my shirt. I did actually had on a B Michele shirt, but the thing about this, I don't think he saw my shirt, and he was like, yeah, I know you, or whatever. And I was like, well, that's what's up.
But I think, like, it was a good thing.
Yeah.
Because it could be something else too.
Yeah.
Hey, that's
I know, right? So he was like, yeah. I was like, well, appreciate the shout out. Hey, I ain't mad about
that's,
the love.
That's that consistency of, right, always being the best version of yourself. Because earlier in this year, I remember us talking about being intentional and what you're doing.
Oh, yes.
And how you
that
doing?
That was our theme for 2019.
And it's worked so far.
Yes.
Like, I mean, I've seen what you've been doing. It's like, man, I need to sign up for some classes.
Well, speaking of, I do have one coming up on November the 6th if you want to come.
Really?
Yeah, so SCORE, I'm going to be doing a branding workshop with SCORE. It's at 10:30 in the morning. And so it's on 6 things you can do to build your brand in 2020.
Man, speaking of showing up, so once again, someone just tuning in. By the way, this is IMRE Focus Radio, 9:30 a.m. The Answer. Your host, Shamai Reed, just in case you forgot. Someone just tuning in right now, where and how can they be a part of this event again?
Okay, so you can go to my Facebook page, Coach B Michele. It's on there, and it says six things you can do in your brand. There's a workshop. You can find it on there. You can find it on Eventbrite as well. But definitely hit me up on Facebook or Instagram, Coach B Michele. Instagram is all together, Coach, then B as in boy, and then Michele with one L. Or Facebook, Coach B Michele on Facebook as well. It's on there, and just click the link and you can register. And so we'll be talking about six really good strategies that you can do to build your brand in this coming 2020.
Man, so I like giving people some homework.
Yes.
Because, you know, that's the whole point. I don't want you to feel good when you listen to the show. I want you to feel like you learned something, you can apply something. So someone listening right now is like, okay, yeah, I like this whole show idea. How you do it?
Well, here's the thing. First of all, show up. No. Well, it's more so about figuring out what you want your customers to say about you. What experience do you want your clients and your customers to have? So once you figure out what do you want people saying about you and your business, then you figure out how do I get that? How do I get those words? How do I have my clients use those words and tell people, oh my God, how great this product is, or how, you know, the service was fabulous, or I really feel like they cared and they listened to me, and you know, whatever it is that you want your clients to feel,
plan it out.
You have to create that. So if that means making sure that you call them ahead of time, like, hey, you send a nice reminder. Maybe you send out a little card on your follow up. You send out a nice thank you for choosing us. Yeah, you send out a follow up email, or you send out a nice little gift, or maybe even when they come to their appointment with you, like if you do coaching or consulting, or if you're in financial services, any of those industries, maybe you give them a nice little gift. You know, a little token or something to take with them.
Give them something they didn't expect.
You go the extra mile.
Yeah.
Give them something that they didn't expect. That follow-up has to be, like, killer. Like, it has to be phenomenal.
Yeah, don't make them, hate to paint a picture, but you know those memes that be popping on Twitter. Don't be that ugly face. Man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So, so if your follow-up. Add value. At the end of the day, make them feel like they're superstar. The only person, the superstar. Yeah.
That VIP, man. Yeah. It shouldn't just be someone that's famous. It should be everybody that chooses your business.
It's VIP.
VIP.
That's real.
I'm just saying, because that's what most, I can say everybody, but that's what most people will want, especially.
Right.
Just think of it. If you're a customer, right, and you're doing some kind of services online or whatever that you're subscribed to, you're expecting some value with your fee that you're being charged.
Yep.
So if you're not getting that value, what happens? You don't catch the next bus.
Yep. That's for sure. Those are facts. All
I'm
day
just
long.
Saying, man.
Those are facts.
It's Sunday
all day
morning.
Long.
We just gotta be real in this morning, man.
Yes, because I think at the end of the day, you have to remember why you started this business. Yeah. Why are you have? Because it's definitely not about you.
Nope.
So you have to totally remove yourself out of the equation. You should have started this business to fill a void, to solve a problem.
Yeah.
In whatever industry you chose. That should be the motivation behind your business.
You serve, you don't get served.
Right.
Ooh.
There you go, you serve.
I'm just saying.
That's right.
You serve, you don't get served.
No, real talk.
No one's supposed to serve you. That's your job.
Right. And so that's part of being an entrepreneur. Part of being in business is to provide a service.
Exactly.
Even if you're selling a product, you're still providing a service along with the product. Mm-hmm. Your customer service needs to be on point. So for those of you that sell items or restaurants or, you know, things like customer service.
You know, I think.
Show up.
I think the greatest frustration is not just not showing up, but like you were saying with the analogy with sports, if you're not training your skill set and practicing
you
to
have
prepare
to
yourself to show up, it's almost like someone driving and they never did driver's ed.
Right. They just out here.
That's a mess.
And you don't crash. So you have to spend, like, you know, again, it's practice. You know, you're in that practice phase. That's you building that relationship. That's networking. That's, you know, getting to know your customer, your client. Then, you know, obviously everything that you talked about and did in the practice phase, you have then game day, you got to execute and deliver.
And then review.
And then after that, it's that post game, that follow up.
Pay attention to the highlights, what worked and what didn't work.
Right.
And then you take that to the next opportunity.
And be open to the feedback that your clients or customers leave, you know, good or bad.
Yeah.
I think at the end of the day.
Man, time goes fast. We're having fun. Right?
This 30 minutes go by real quick.
B Michele in the building on the 12th floor here on Sunday morning, 9:30 a.m. The Answer. Want to thank you for being on the show. And real quick, before we let you go, I'm your host, Shemaya Reed, iamrefocusradio.com. You can go there and check out our archives and our bonus shows. But before we let B Michele leave, how can people reach you?
So you can find me on all platforms. That's Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Coach B Michele. Also, our website is bmichele.com. That's B-M-I-C-H-E-L-E, 1-L, and Michele.com.
Well, there you have it. We appreciate everyone for tuning in. Catch us next week. But until then, like we say every single show, keep God first, stay focused, and peace.
This is Gene Hildebrand with Engage SA. For a comprehensive listing of Christian events in San Antonio each week, check out the Engage Christian calendar. The calendar is distributed via email each week to about 700 subscribers absolutely free of charge as a ministry to the San Antonio Christian community. To subscribe, go to Engage SA on Facebook and click the button for email list. Or you can find the calendar posted on Engage SA as well as 17 other group sites. I'm Gene Hildebrand. Engage.
Hi, San Antonio. Need a barber? Visit our good friend, Rico Rodriguez, the owner of Rockefeller's Barbershop in San Antonio, Texas, 1733 Babcock Road, and book your appointment today by calling 210-782-5188.